Well, I've got to get it right back. I got this material now, right? I found a place to go pick it up. But go over to handmade to find that same kind of rhythm. But that's the pain in the ass when you're trying to do a real restore stuff. You know, I don't usually like to do it because it takes so much time when you're trying to make it light on the nose. But this car means a lot. It's got an extremely rare motor. Very seldom do you ever have seen the way the exhaust pipes come out. They come out through the top instead of down the bottom. Which was horsepower.
Quicker scavenging? Pardon? Quicker scavenging?
Well, the way they feed, this is every distance from each exhaust and everything is exactly the same right to here. And it all chokes back down, and this means a tremendous amount of diameter right here. And then it tapers and gets bigger. And what it does, that actually, by the exhaust going through, helps suck that thing right out of there. And it makes horsepower just from that. It becomes so, then you feel it all stainless.
So,
I took the whole motor. I got another motor, brand new one. I took and sat there. It was all apart. I sat there for hours and smoothed every part of the whole motor, fit every one of the things right to a T, so it's right on there. No lip or no nothing. And then put it all back together. Only to try to do something that most people don't. It's not, I'm not encouraged to do this thing. I try to do it like that. Now I'm changing all the fuel lines coming in because it gets too hot for this. And you can get that hot and you can get it. And in between here and the body here, it's got